Hi everybody and welcome back to Amazing Tech for All. Today we're diving into the apps that's available on TrueNAS. So let's dive right in. We log in with the TrueNAS admin and password. Do it. There we go. So we'll first be faced with a dashboard, as you can see over here, and then we can navigate down through the apps. There's no apps installed at the moment, so we will go to check available apps and we will scroll down to Pi-hole, which is a DNS and a store for Pi-hole is a DNS as an ad filter. So, all we have to do is click on install. Here are the application or the functions that will let you know on the right hand side if there's any configuration that you need to do. Usually there will be a little arrow over here to let you know, or a mark to let you know that you need to install or to add features or to add configuration. The dashboard, the landing page, once you've logged into TrueNAS, will give you an idea of all the details about the system, including how much storage you have, how much free space you have, what your operating system is, how busy your operating system is, and so on. So it's actually quite, this is a good measure of what's going on your system. We are going to the apps. This is where all the features can be extended of TrueNAS. So there's a lot that can be added. We're going to do something simple today, and our plan is to install Pi-hole. Pi-hole is an ad blocker for your network. So it filters out ads and it has a bunch of other features. Let's go on to it. Click on Pi-hole, click on install. And on the right hand side, these are the categories that needs to be configured. In this case, we can go with the defaults. We don't need to change anything. We'll just scroll down and get to the install button. This install process involves the downloading of a Docker image. So what Pi-hole, or rather what TrueNAS does, it makes Docker available without having to use the command line. There's no CLI involved. It will pull the application, install it or deploy it, and it will make it available.
Okay, now that we've got Pi-hole running, I'm going to click on the web UI button. As you can see, we have Pi-hole's dashboard open now. Here you can see the total number of queries, the queries that are blocked, the percentage of blocked queries, and then list of domains. So in order to make changes to this, we can very well, firstly, in order to start using this, we need to point clients towards this DNS. We will do that in just a second, spinning up another device. But let's just take a look and see, this is where you can, under lists, is an area that you can add block lists. So you can either add a list or allow list as well. The site that we can get some of these lists from is Firebog.net, I believe. Let's take a look. And yes, here's a suspicious list that we can add. You want to block a variety of adverts. You want to block other types of items. Let's just see. Malware and so on. We can just select. In fact, we can select a few of them. Add them, copy this, and we will stick them into our list over here. Then we will click add. Now you can see the number, they've all successfully been added. To bring them all online and to synchronize them, you have to click on the online button. Click on update the gravity list. This will take a few seconds. While that's happening, please, if you find this useful, please comment or click on the like button, thumbs up, and for future videos, please subscribe. Okay, let us back to the video. Let's see what's going on over here. Yes, that is going. It's retrieving all the information successfully. And we've completed the, so the list or the addition of lists. So we scroll to the top. We go back to dashboards. You'll see that it's now gone up to 1.3 million sites, domains that are in the block list. I'm going to attempt to make a client speak to this domain in a second, or to this DNS, and I'll get the client to start using this DNS. Okay, so I just started a small VM to demonstrate how Pi-hole would work. Firstly, we have a network connected virtual machine. We are going to connect and to the internet. That's already connected to the internet. But it does not use the Pi-hole as a DNS machine yet. So I'm going to go on to cn.com, see how many ads they have. So usually this website got lots of ads associated with it. Let's see, generally would ton of ads here. This is what it looks like now. Or we've changed the DNS. So we're going to go to the network settings. Settings. Just see here. We right click on the internet connection and edit connection. Take a second, because I'm using a tool machine that is not even installed, it's just running off the memory of the ISO file. Click on IPv4 and we'll change from DHCP to DHCP address only, and then we will set a IP address, which will be the IP address of this server, the TrueNAS server that is now running Pi-hole as a DNS server. Select that, put that. Right. Right. 1.22.31. That should do. Now let's just disconnect and reconnect. Connect. Connect. Fine now. See this page. See if any adverts that are. Oh, look at all the queries that is now suddenly being taken place. 96 queries have been blocked on one page of CNN. So the percentage of content that's actually being blocked is 76% of the content that you did not ask for. So the page doesn't look very different. Let's take a look at some of the other sites. What's another one that will be popular? Sky News. Sky News, let's take a look at how many ads are blocked here. This is Google's page that are blocking. That's where ads are being blocked. And here you can now see the amount of ads that are being blocked on the various websites. And this is by using Pi-hole to block content or block ads on your network. It can also be used to block categories and so on, but this was just a quick demonstration of how to deploy Pi-hole on TrueNAS and how to make use of it. Thank you very much. If you found this useful, please click on the like button. Please subscribe for future videos. And thank you for watching.